Good evening, everybody. Cynthia, you're too kind, and thank you all so much for this wonderful and beautiful recognition. And of course, I think many of you may know, some of you know Cynthia, because when Cynthia asked us to be a part of this tonight, we knew we were destined to say yes, because Cynthia has the powers of persuasion.
That, and she knows where we live.
But like any good journalist, of course, I wanted to think a little bit more about this organization and how it might be relevant to me. And I got thinking about my own history, as Cynthia said, in small town Georgia. And I remember growing up in Little Perry, Georgia, in the shadow of segregation. And my mother had a couple of older relatives who could barely read and write. In fact, she even had an uncle who I remember signed X for his name on documents. As a child, I remember thinking, that's very strange, given how much I loved school and how much I loved books and any book that I can get my hands on, going to the summer library challenge. But I later, of course, understood that this great uncle endured a time in history when what I considered to just be a right was something that was actually dangerous for his relatives, black citizens. It was forbidden. The practice, of course, used as a weapon to deny dreams, truth, and privileges. Well, today, his niece is making her living reading and writing. I stand on my great uncle's shoulders tonight and those of countless others for whom literacy was not a privilege, but as I said, a danger which could have cost them their lives. Well, thankfully, those days of fear are over, but as Cynthia so poignantly told us, the challenge of having a literate society where the sky is the limit, not really.
Well, and that's where Literacy Partners comes in. For more than 50 years, you all have been there helping adults who have somehow been denied the dream of literacy and help them realize their potential to thrive in this world, and that's a huge difference that you have helped make. My folks, Al and Isabel Roker, were big believers in education. My mom was a voracious reader who passed that love of reading on to me. My favorite spot growing up was the New York City Public Library. I know it's hard to believe, looking at me, that I was not a gifted athlete. I know, really. But I was a gifted reader. Reading was my gateway to meeting people, going places, and going to events that I could only dream about. The St. Albans branch of the Queens Public Library in elementary school was with Dennis Walcott, was one of my heroes. And then when I went to high school, Xavier High School on 16th Street. I'm going to just start naming things and getting applause. That's all. I went to the Donnell Public Library on 52nd Street in Manhattan.
Yes.
All right. No, no, but, and by the way, it is criminal to think that in the greatest city in the world, there are cuts to the public library system that are going to reduce our libraries to 5 days a week. That's unconscionable. We are both very fortunate to have had rich lives filled with books and learning, to actually both have authored books, and it is an honor tonight to celebrate the work being done to make sure that so many others in this city and this country have that right. We are honored and touched to be here with our fellow honorees, Elizabeth and Michael, and to be sharing this important evening with Viola, Ethan, Michael, and Julia Alvarez. Congratulations to all of you, and thank you so much for my smaller honor than my wife got.
I think that was mine.